Today, we'll be looking at the Z9's raw implementation, in particular, HE star or high efficiency star and high efficiency raws. And is there any difference between it and lossless? I'm Richard, welcome to ZP Productions, and today we'll look at the Z9's compression formats, and does it really matter? Now, the thing is, today's camera has a lot of megapixels, and storage does matter. You know, if you're rattling away 100 to 200 shots, they can easily rack up 5GB, 10GB, or even hundreds of gigabytes of files. Now, in fact, I have all three cameras here, and let me put up a chart on the various formats they have and the sizes of those formats. Now, for Canon, there was never uncompressed. You cannot choose uncompressed. You can either choose, you know, standard RAW, which I believe is lossless compressed already, followed by their compressed RAW. And for Canon's implementation of their compressed RAW, or should I say lossless compressed RAW, it is pretty good. You can see, you know, it is less than 1 megabyte per megapixel. Now, for Sony, the uncompressed is huge, 100 megabytes. And, you know, put in perspective, 10 shots will be 1 gigabyte, 100 shots will be 10 gigabyte, and 1,000 shots will be 100 gigabyte. So, you know, it makes a difference. So, most people wanted the lossless compressed because in the past, Sony had compressed RAW, and compressed RAW has artifacts. In fact, let me show you one here. You know, you have to push like extreme. You can see this green color stuff at the side. This is the artifact of the compressed RAW in Sony itself. And as such, lossless compress came in, and in fact, lossless compress and compress have very little difference, as you can see in the chart earlier. So today we are talking about Z9, and Z9 is very interesting because they have the lossless compress, they do have uncompressed edition, and then they have the what I say as HE star, high efficiency star, and then high efficiency. Now, why it's so unique is because these two compression is actually in collaboration with a company called IntoPix, and I believe the technology they use is called Tico RAW. And inside the specification, there are three types: mathematically lossless, near lossless, and visually lossless. To the layman, means that you cannot see the difference between that and lossless RAW, but to a computer who's computing, the first one is mathematically lossless, which means the computer compute, it will probably have no difference, while the other two will have some difference between it and lossless compress. With this implementation, the size difference are huge. It's not like the Sony's compressed version, which is almost the same size as lossless, and the Canon's compressed version, which has tons of artifacts and lose a lot of details. The Nikon's version, based on Tico RAW, should be almost the same as lossless compress, at a much smaller file size. I do not know which specification they use. I'm assuming that one is probably mathematically lossless and then visually lossless, or near lossless and visually lossless. But today, let's take a look at the compression itself. Let's take a look at this outdoor shoot first. So in this outdoor shoot, as I said earlier in my previous review, you probably can't tell a difference. After applying grading, you still can't tell a difference. And then just to retry this again, I did an outdoor shoot and it seems to be the same. Even if I zoom in, I really can't tell a difference between all three after applying the gradings and stuff. They look almost the same. If there's any difference, it may be the sun just moving in that particular second itself. So at least for normal photo shoots between all three formats, even the HE to the lossless, I really can't tell. I mean, if you look at some other reviewers, talk on it, there seems to be some difference in terms of contrast and shadows, but when I apply the exact same grading, there is no difference itself. Now, you may be thinking that maybe the way I do it is slightly different, and that's maybe possible, but I applied the same profile. So if you really want to try yourself, you can purchase the RAW below to support the models in this test itself. That is, of course, for the outdoor shoots. At least outdoor shoots-wise, I really can't tell a difference. So let's take a look at indoor and doing a test with my wall of push-ins. I literally call that because that's my wife's favorite soft toy. So in this wall of push-ins, I did a few ways. I shot at ISO 100 and I underexposed it, and then I re-overexposed it by 5 stops. And I went around to see in the shadows, is there a difference in noise? Is there a difference in details? And I can honestly tell you, I can't tell a difference. I really can't tell the difference. I don't see much difference in color. I don't see much difference in noise. I don't even see much difference in the detail itself. And, you know, I can run you through a few photos here at ISO 100 and doing that. No difference at all. So I went to try another. This time I shoot at ISO 6400, which is a very noisy ISO. And sometimes they say that when you compress it, if you have a lot of noise, the compression will exaggerate the noise and whatever. So I just wanted to make sure that I tried that. So at ISO 6400, also no difference. I mean, let me show you a few shots here. ISO 6400 between lossless and HE, I can't tell a difference. And the reason why I'm doing lossless and HE because the file size is the huge difference. I mean, one is like 40% and one is like 100%. So one is like 50 meg, the other one is like 20 meg. So if there is a difference, if this guy shows, maybe there's a difference. If these guys don't show, maybe there's no difference. So I went to look around the entire screen. I can't find any difference at all, really. And then the next one is that maybe, you know, it's like the Sony itself, it requires light tubes. So I set up two light tubes and then I shot the light tubes itself. And then I bring up the exposure by about 3 to 4 stops again this time. And then I take a look around the screen. Once again, between lossless and HE, no difference at all. So I'm wondering, where is that artifact? Where's the potential artifact? So I went to go and dig a little bit. As I said, Sony has artifacts, Canon has artifacts. So Canon artifacts are straightforward. In fact, take a look at this. This is Canon's artifact between lossless and their compressed version. You can see it's quite terrible, the compress. So don't use Canon compress unless you are desperate to use it. While for Sony itself, there is artifacts, but only in this scenario here, where you shoot a very slim light tube, and then there is a very dark area, and then there's a flare. And you can see in this particular photo, after zooming in like a few 100%, you can see the flare is different. The lossless on the left side is different from the compressed version on the right side for the Sony cameras itself. You can see that the flare has some weird patterns. So I went to redo the shot again with the Nikon camera, and I can tell you again, once again, no difference. Let me show you at the exact same area where Sony has artifacts, the Nikon version in the lossless versus HE, no difference at all. And I took another part of the tube again. Lossless versus HE, no difference at all. So how do I actually summarize all this is that maybe I really can't see a difference. Maybe it's truly visually lossless. At least in my editing, in my bringing up of 3 to 4 stops, in my portrait shoots outdoors, and in my test shots indoors, I cannot visually see a huge difference or any form of difference, in fact. So if there's a difference, it's probably really small, and probably only when you do extreme pushing that may happen, or only when you do extreme contrast situation. But I really shot relatively high contrast situation and it doesn't appear. So I'm not too sure. So if you know or you experience it, just write down in the comments below. But at least from my test itself, between lossless compress and HE, there's almost no difference at all. At least today's test shows there's almost no difference at all. But for my own personal good feeling, I would recommend using HE Star because at least I know that I cannot spot a difference between both of them, and I know that HE Star should be better, and based on Tico's raw specification, this should be near lossless or mathematically lossless. I would take HE Star, which will save me a good 40% size from, you know, 50 megabyte to 30 megabyte. And if I do 100 shots, that's a saving of 100 shots, that's a saving of 2 gigabytes. That's a huge difference. So if you are a Nikon Z9 photographer, you should consider using HE Star rather than lossless, because at least for me, I can't tell a difference. And maybe for you, you probably will not do the test like me. You will not be shooting such extreme scenarios. Unless you're a landscape photographer and you're shooting wide landscape which have high contrast difference, maybe then, if you do see any artifacts, do tell me. I'm really interested in it. But if not, that's about it for today. I hope you enjoy this, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.